You and me got a whole lot of history.
Buenos dias.
Welcome to the Galapagos Islands.
We are travel journalists, Kyle and Kayla. We're an ordinary couple with a love for travel and eyes for extraordinary experiences. This is our story as we live with happiness, find adventure, and have courage in our everyday life in new journeys around the world. Don't you know? We stayed at a hotel called Casa. It was right on the bay, and Jackie owns it with her family. She is so amazing, like, so
she
kind.
She upgraded us just because.
Yeah, she was just, like, kind because...
That's just how they are.
Yeah.
Their motto on the island is inner peace and relaxation, and it shows.
The wildlife around the island is just totally insane. Like, the moment that we had gotten there, it was just sea lions, crabs, iguanas,
pelicans,
turtles.
1, 2, 3, uh-huh.
To conserve the land and, you know, just not destroy the habitat for the wildlife, and it really shows when you go there. Kyle and I were on a bike ride one day, and we get down to this pier, and we notice that there's a woman there, like, sticking stuff in the water. So
she had a she had a gigantic piece of rebar, and she was trying to pull what we thought was just this little circle piece of plastic out of the water at the time.
Which also, even if this was the case that she was just trying to get the plastic out of
it
the water,
sense.
Totally, like, makes sense for the
because
island.
Because everyone there is super, super, like, conservationist, like, keep everything clean, no trash in the water. And so I thought I'd help her out. She's so old.
She's going to get, she's got the rebar, and then she goes back, and she gets this, like, long, flimsy stick that's not going to do anything. She's trying to reach in the water. I'm like, babe, just jump in and get it.
Yeah.
So Kyle and I are on this bike ride right now, and there's a local that's trying to get that little piece of plastic right there out of the water.
If I can climb up this tire, I can.
The determination to get this little piece of plastic out. Go ahead, babe. Go jump in and get it. Babe, worst case, just climb up over there.
I'm gonna get it.
Sit on my hand.
Pocket's clear?
You guys say it's from over there, right?
Yeah.
Yay! Is that a fishing line?
Yeah.
Mi héroe.
No.
She maybe told me, but I didn't understand, that this was a fishing line wrapped around this plastic reel and that there was a fish on it. So I jump in and out of nowhere I'm getting wrapped up in fishing wire, and I panicked a little. I was like, what is happening here? And then I start getting pulled. These fish were not small fish. It had to be like this big. And I'm now probably what, like 80 feet, 100 feet from getting out of the water. And now I gotta swim with one hand while I'm trying to fish with my other hand and wrap this wire around.
When I was planning this trip, I just really, really wanted to swim with sea lions. And I think naturally they're just playful animals and very curious. So Kyle and I had gone to like three different beaches and we just weren't getting lucky between the tides, or like they weren't in the water. I was like, let's just go try this one beach. And Kyle's like, we've been swimming all day, like, I don't know. And I was like, no, come on, like, let's go. And I am so happy we went. It was just like so magical. Kyle and I swam out like past the waves, and there were probably four or five of us, five of the sea lions that were just like ready to play and ready to go.
Yeah, it's kind of like a, it seemed to me kind of like a dance. Like you would do something and then they'd do it. And then like you just go back and forth playing, and it is like crazy cool how close they get.
We went on a tour with Wreck Bay Diving, and we had an amazing guide. His name is Christian. So Victor Rock is a, basically what, volcanic eruption?
It's the production of a volcanic eruption. The way it works is that the stuff was blown up into the air, and as it layered down, it compacted on top of itself, and after years of erosion, whether wind, water, it created this
gigantic rock.
El León de Dormir, Duermo.
They call it Sleeping Lion, because yeah. It looks like a sleeping sea lion if you use your imagination. And it's supposed to be one of the most biodiverse areas within the Galapagos.
And like, it is.
Top three snorkeling and diving areas, and just incredible.
I couldn't use it, like, using my full imagination, it didn't even compare to what it actually was, like what I thought it was gonna be. was nothing compared to how it actually was.
We saw everything.
Eagle rays, golden rays, every type of fish you could think of.
Sharks.
Sea lions, turtles, sharks. We saw Galapagos sharks, white-tipped reef sharks, hammerhead shark. And for me, that was like huge, because like growing up, I always like watched these like Animal Planet and
Kyle wants to be Sea Ruin.
I've always wanted to like free swim with sharks.
Show me your turtle sign.
Sea turtle.
Show me your happy sea turtle.
Other places do have their own animals. Like I know there's flamingos there and
penguins
and there's other
some things we didn't get to see,
wildlife species. So I would love to go back and do it again, but for our first time, I mean, that was incredible.
I like that stuff. I'm the village crazy lady.
A thing that stuck out to me was I was talking to one of the restaurant owners, and he was explaining how this pandemic has affected their island, where 90% of...
Well, at first he didn't even say that. He was like, oh, you guys are here at, like, the perfect time because there's not a lot of people here. And, like, I took that and I was like, how are you guys
yeah,
doing?
He didn't just come up to us and talk about it. We kind of pushed to ask him, like, what's going on their end. And, like...
And you could just see his facial expression just, like, totally change. He was like, we're struggling.
Yeah, it's hard for them because, like, everybody's travel shaming each other and afraid to travel. Like, just follow the regulations and get out there. And, like, because these people are struggling just as much as anyone else is, if not more. And do whatever you can to help out. They are so nice, so friendly. Like, they don't, like... Taking a tip is, like, weird for them. Like, they don't like that. Like, they're just appreciative of, like, getting the value of what they give you. Not more, not less. Like,
he basically said that they are just living to try and pay the bills right now, which is, like, super heartbreaking.
He said everyone's just getting a cut. Everybody's just getting as much as they can out of the money that they get in. And they split it evenly. And they, like... They're just all trying to find a system in which they could survive this pandemic until it's over.
Yeah, so that's really tough. And, like, I see both sides of it. But on our way here, like, there are very strict regulations, and you have to follow them.
They won't let you in unless you do the right thing. And
they'll, like, call the lab to make sure that you got your test. And, like, they deny people because... Like, they didn't get the right test or, you know, whatever it had to be. So, these people that are, like, you know, travel shaming others, and I'm sure that we'll probably get something. But we're following the rules. Like, we're wearing our mask out in public. We're doing what we need to do. We're supporting these people that are, like, hanging on by a thread.
Mm-hmm. You just don't, like, I don't want to see these types of areas, like, fall or crumble because... of something like a pandemic where, like, we can still travel, we can still go and do these, like, things, but
just take the precautions that you would at home and do it there.
The idea to avoid doing that because of, like, it looks bad or, like, people are telling you it looks bad when it really doesn't is, like, mind-blowing to me. So that's a big thing I learned on this trip.
We didn't do our high and a low.
Oh, well, my high... would probably be some wood sharks. My low would be leaving so soon.
You stole my low.
Damn.
My high was swimming with the sea lions, which is so cool. Like, making the video just made me cry. And then my low was leaving. I don't want to leave. We'll be back.
Yeah, we'll be back.